Chairman of FCDC, Honorable His Excellency, the Governor of Mandera, has read the statement on behalf of the Pastoral Parliamentary Group and the governors, and our speakers were here. And we are from all shades of political opinion. And our time will come in every political dispensation that you withdraw from your political party, you withdraw from your other business, and like our cows and camels come back home in the evening, we have withdrawn ourselves today here, and we have decided that this political conversation of inclusivity, this political conversation that has been going on for the last 2 years, where is the place for a pastoralist citizen within the context of the Kenyan society? So the issue that we have raised here, some of them are very dear to us. Resource allocation, representation, education, issuance of ID card, livestock marketing, those are dear to the pastoral community. What do we share with the people of Kenya, and we feel we must speak about the independence of judiciary? As the Governor Robert said, everywhere in the world you go, even in the US, the other two arms of government, you know, the legislature and the executive, and I'm speaking myself as a former majority leader, they are buddies, they're like twins, they can go to bed together. So where do minorities and people like the pastoralists run to? They run to an independent judiciary. So the 2010 Constitution gave us that judiciary. It has its own challenges. The judiciary, we are not saying, is not having challenges. It needs reform within itself, but we are saying we must uphold the independence of the judiciary. We're talking about IBC. We share with the rest of Kenyans. But as a region, we're saying, yes, IBC needs reform. But again, we are very much worried of the players playing a role in being the arbiter in any election competition. All we are saying is the Constitution in Article, I think, 251 created certain commissions. The Auditor General, the Office of the DPP, the Controller of Budget, the IBC. These are people who make every day in their duty, they make either popular or unpopular decisions on whoever it concerns. So these are deliberate. The Constitution in 2010, which I myself and a number of colleagues here participated in the Constitution of that time. So we feel the IEBC must be an independent arbiter if we have to have a very good electoral system. So in a nutshell, what are we saying? In a nutshell, we are telling constitutional making process is a citizen driven. We, the Pastoral Parliamentary Group, presented, and you people can get the clips, we asked even for a pure parliamentary system. Even a comma of our presentation is not found in the current BBI proposal. So the president, in his wisdom in Boma, said, let's build consensus. Let's come together. We are saying, let us come together. Let us build consensus. Let us, everybody brings his issue on the table. And for your information, the MPs secured CDF yesterday in Naivasha. So the document was opened yesterday. I mean, I was not there, but I'm a happy man. My colleagues were in Naivasha, fought hard. So the document has already been opened. CDF, so we are saying, that window which the members of parliament use CDF, we want to use it for issues on revenue. We want to use it for our issue on representation. And I think, as Honorable Lekin has said, the ultimate goal of what we are doing is to amend the Constitution. Am I right?
Yes.
So who is this person saying you can't amend the proposal? I mean, we want to amend the Constitution. the supreme law. You know, if you ask some of us, our by supreme law is the Holy Quran. But now let me even say the supreme law in a secular setup like Kenya, the supreme law is the constitution. So we are amending the constitution, and every Kenyan has a right to amend the constitution. So you are very hypocritical if you tell me that I cannot amend the proposal to amend the constitution. So we are saying we are good. I think we want dialogue. We want not only us. We want even people who have got issues with us in our document. We want to engage them. We want to give this document to the Kenyan people. If they want to engage other colleagues in parliament, other colleagues, the other governor or governors who dialogue with other governors, we want to party leaders. By the end of the day, we want a document that everybody in Kenya feels home. We will be cheating the country, as my final statement. We will be cheating our parties, we will be cheating the country if we go and say the pastoral community is happy with the document. We have issues, these are the issues.
Yes.
The people of Kenya, you have heard us.
Yes.
We are waiting for that discussion, and I think when we get there, where we are part of the consensus, give and take, and we have our reasonable minimum. Our chair for FCDC has said it. We are happy with some of the gains in the BBI. We are not happy with some of the proposals in BBI. And for your information, every politics is local. The people of Garissa Township will help me. Not today. You know, look at what Wangari Maathai said on environment. She said those who are destroying the environment will not pay the ultimate price. The generations to come will pay the price.
Yes.
We as leaders of today, we don't want to pay a price for our pastoralist generations to come.
Okay.
We don't want.
Okay.
So we are saying,
okay.
Please take care.